हाय एवरीवन, क्लास नाइन्थ। आई एम राशिद खान फ्रॉम लक्ष्मी प्रसाद मेमोरियल पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। क्लास टुडे हियर विल हैव टू डिस्कस ऑन द चैप्टर नंबर टू, दैट इज मैटर प्योर अराउंड अस प्योर, इन विच सम ऑफ द टॉपिक गिवन आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड, बट द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन ऑन विच वी हैव टू डिस्कस्ड। सो द टॉपिक इज सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस, separation of substances like solid substances may be separated by the different means in which some of the process I have already explained. Here is two most common like sand and salt. This can be separated by using solvent. When the solvent is mixed with both of them, like the sand and water, what will happen? Here is water. Some amount of water added, in which here is salt added to it, and rest of the amount is of sand particles. So what will happen to the next when we mix with all the remaining portion of this particular solution is what? It get dissolved completely. The salt molecules or the salt get dissolved completely. It can be dissolved in it. And here this one is salt. So the salt molecule already dissolved in it, and here is rest of sand molecule. Sand molecule is remaining over there. So simply it can be separated by filter paper very easily by using the simple paper, by using filter paper. This can be separate. Here is salt get dissolved and sand remain here as an insoluble material. So it is another way by which the two solid particles get separated from one another. The next one is, that is to separate the mixture of sulfur and sand particles. What will happen then? Suppose if there is a sand particles, F here is in which if there is sulfur molecules, it is a sulfur and that one is sand. What will happen then? When they are mixed together, this will form a varied different colors like this. If it is having the different color, so how they can be separated? They can be separated by using carbon disulfide. They can be separated by using carbon disulfide. Suppose here is sulfur. When the sulfur is added to it, the mixture of sulfur and sand shaken with one another, what will happen then? They can be mixed to one another and they can be easily filtered. The carbon disulfide turn into the carbon, and sulfur is added to the sulfide. So that one forms the carbon disulfide. By using it will be separate, but the remaining portion of the sand is separate through the filter paper. So that is what the salt, sugar and carbon disulfide, like a carbon, and also they are insoluble, the insoluble in carbon disulfide. So what will happen? They can easily be separated by using a filter paper. So this is another method by which we can separate these two type of a solid materials. Now we have to move on to the next one, that is separation of a mixture of common salt and ammonium chloride. That means common salt and ammonium chloride. This can be separated by using a method called sublimation. By the process of sublimation, the salt, common salt and ammonium chloride, suppose this one is a common salt and if it is mixed with ammonium chloride, what will happen there? NH4Cl, ammonium chloride, and here is salt. So what will happen then? By the process of sublimation, sublimation is what actually? The sublimation is it when these salt get converted into the gas, that is not salt, the ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride get converted into the vapors without changing into liquid. When it get changes into the vapors, so the process by which when the solid particles get converted into the vapors without changing it into its intermediary form, that is liquid, it will convert it to the vapor. That one is called as sublimation. So by the process of sublimation, the salt particles get separated from the ammonium chloride by the process of sublimation. This can be done very easily with the help of a inverted funnel, and that should be kept into a china dish. When the china dish is allowed to get touch into the it may be fixed with any cotton, or this one is packed with the Vaseline, so the gas it could not pass out, and hence the vaporizations will take place, and due to which here is ammonium chloride take place here, and this one here is what, here is salts are obtained. So the process is what actually this one is, the sublimation, by which the salt can get separated from ammonium chloride by the process of sublimation. So it is another way by which the solid particles get separated from the other solid particles by the process of sublimation. Now the next one is separation by the magnets. The magnet gets separated, the mixture of iron filling and sulfur, it is a very common. You can see when the iron powder, or you can say the iron fillings, suppose here is iron fillings, if it is iron fillings and in which there is a sulfur powder added to this, sulfur powder, when the sulfur powder is added to this, this one is a mixture of iron and sulfur. So how they can be separated? They can be easily separated by using this can be separated by using a magnet. So through the magnet they can be easily, the iron gets separated. Iron gets separated over here. Iron gets separated over here, and rest of sulfur powder remain as usual. Sulfur powder is used as usual, they can be remain here in the other vessels. So this is the process by which we can easily go through the separate the particles of mixture like iron and sulfur. Here is the most important criteria by which these solid particles get separated. And you know that very easily and a very common process, that is using magnet from the scrap yard. From the scrap yard, when the iron gets separated from the magnetic crane, when the magnetic crane get used to separate the iron for a very large unit, and a very large unit, when there is a iron gets separated by the magnetic crane, or you can say the electromagnet, by using an electromagnet we can use the different scraps on which there is a number of the different type of unused material. It is the scrap. From the scrap yard only the iron gets separated through the electromagnet or the magnetic crane. So that one is another way by which the solid particles get separated from another solid with the help of magnet. And here is also the magnet can separate the iron from the sulfur as well. Why? Because the sulfur and iron get mixed with one another, and they can be easily separated. Iron fillings. These are what actually? This is the iron fillings. These iron fillings are get separated from the sulfur by using the magnet. And here is also the magnet can be used to separate the solid to solid. That means the iron from the scrap yard. So it is another way by which we can separate the iron from the scrap yard, or for the many different type of garbages present in it, or the number of scrap into it. So this can be easily separated into the form of solid-solid separation. In which if there is sulfur molecules, it is a sulfur and that one is sand. What will happen then? When they are mixed together, this will form a varied different colors like this. If it is having the different color, so how they can be separated? They can be separated by using carbon disulfide. They can be separated by using carbon disulfide. Suppose here is sulfur. When the sulfur is added to it, the mixture of sulfur and sand shaken with one another, what will happen then? They can be mixed to one another and they can be easily filtered. The carbon disulfide turn into the carbon, and sulfur is added to the sulfide. So that one forms the carbon disulfide by using it will be separate. But the remaining portion of the sand is separate through the filter paper. So that is what the salt, sugar and carbon disulfide, like a carbon, and also they are insoluble, the insoluble in carbon disulfide. So what will happen? They can easily be separated by using a filter paper. So this is another method by which we can separate these two type of solid materials. Now we have to move on to the next one, that is separation of a mixture of common salt and ammonium chloride. That means common salt and ammonium chloride. This can be separated by using a method called sublimation. By the process of sublimation, the salt, common salt and ammonium chloride. Suppose this one is a common salt, and if it is mixed with ammonium chloride, what will happen there? NH4Cl, ammonium chloride, and here is salt.